Hello again everyone, this is the CRUZ engineering video tutorial. In this video we will discuss about simple stresses. Let's consider a board and it will be loaded at P at this side, and of course to maintain equilibrium dapat equals lang sa kabila. Okay. Now imagine if this P is loaded along this longitudinal axis of the bar, that will cause a uniform stress of that bar, and that is what we call the axial stress, or from the word axis, diba? Kaya naging axial stress. Okay, now imagine we will cut this perpendicular from the axis ito. So ito yung plane na makikita natin dyan. Okay, so yun, ikakat natin. Now itong T, dapat to maintain equilibrium, dapat may force din dito na opposite sa kanya. Okay? So, ayun. Itong P will be distributed all throughout this area. And that should be opposite to that direction. So, dito, I represented it as a very small forces. Yun. So, this very small forces, pag i-add natin lahat yan, dapat equivalent to P lang yan. Or resultant na is T. Again, to maintain equilibrium. Okay. Now, these very small forces are what we call the stress sigma. Okay? So, that is denoted as sigma, that is just the force P divided by the area, perpendicular to that area. So, hint of the normal stress, yung force P mo dapat perpendicular sa area na kinoconsider mo. Okay? Yun. And that's what we call as normal or the axial stress. Okay. How about if this bar, the same bar, is loaded perpendicular from its longitudinal axis? Yun. And again, I will cut in this manner and exposing this. So, if that P is going downward, dapat ikontra yan ng going upward forces. And these forces are what we call the shear. Or mas general, tawagin siyang average shear, because in reality, it will not be evenly distributed sa area niya. Okay? May formula na yung exact shear talaga at every point yung makukuha natin. But here in engineering, this is acceptable, the average shear stress. Okay? So that is just the shear force D divided by this area. And again, the hint of shear stress, dapat yung force mo is parallel to the area. Unlike sa normal stress, dapat perpendicular ang force mo sa area. Okay? And again, that is what called the average shear stress. Okay, let's consider an example. Calculate the normal and shear stress on plane AA. So, ito yung plane AA natin, and that is 15 degrees with the horizontal axis. Okay, para mas maging klaro, i-cut ka to. Ito yung pinakita ko sa 2D, ito yung 2-dimensional. So, this dimension 70 is ito yung perpendicular. Okay, so first, unahin natin yung normal stress. Ano yung normal stress? So, dapat yung force mo is perpendicular to the area, di ba? So, take note, this is the area na pinoconsider natin. So, ang normal stress dyan is ito, 90 degrees with that plane. Ito yung plane man, plane AA. So, that should be the cosine component of that P. And again, the shear stress naman, dapat parallel yung force na i-consider natin. Parallel sa area. Ito man yung area. So, that is the P sine of 15. So, bakit ganito yung components natin? Okay, tingnan nyo. If this is 15 degrees, itong line AA natin, 15 degrees with the horizontal, so of course, ito, 15 degrees rin from the horizontal. And take note, this is 90 degrees. So, ang matira dito, dapat 90 minus 15. Okay, andito tayo, 90 minus 15. And of course, this is also 90 degrees. If this is 90 minus 15, this is di 15 degrees dito. Okay? Or pag na-scale mo ang drawing mo, makikita mo naman ano yung mas small opening. So ito man yung 15, so ito yung small opening mo. Ito yung makikita mo that nasan yung 15 degrees mo. Or nasan yung theta mo. That it is best na alam talaga natin paano siya i paano natin i-locate yung angle na yan pag nakaslant na tayo. Okay? Now, normal stress. So, the normal stress of this area, dapat ito, P cosine of 15 divided by that area. Okay, before that, take note, this is the area. The area must be, ito, dimension, that is 50. Now, 50 times this length. Okay, take note, this length is not the same with this length. Kasi nakaslant na yan. So, that length should be solved first. That is cosine 15. Take note, this is slant. And we can create a right triangle. That is 15. Cosine 15, that is adjacent. Ano yung adjacent mo? Ito. That is 70 divided by x. Tawagin ko yung x ang dimension dyan. And that x is 72.47 millimeters. So, i-highlight ko yun. Yun yung x mo. Pag tinignan mo dito, ayun yun. Okay. Now, we have all the all needed parameters natin para ma-solve na ang problem. Okay, unahin natin yung normal stress on plane AA. So, the normal stress dapat is the perpendicular force 20, gawin ko siyang newtons, 20,000, take note, P is 20. So, 20,000, ito yung perpendicular force na cosine 15 divided by area. So, that is 50 times x, 72.47, and that should give 5.33 megapascal. Okay? Now, how about the shear stress at plane AA? Okay, then, shear stress dapat ang force P mo is parallel sa area. So, the parallel force here is ito, P sine 50. So, that should be 20,000 sine 50 divided by the same area. And that should be 1.43 megapascal. Ayun. So, I hope you learned something about simple stresses. And again, study the principle kung ano yung way of solving that problem, no? In that specific problem, para mas kahit anong quiz ng problem, masosolve mo talaga. Okay, I hope you learned something, and thank you everyone, and God bless.